What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. Guess what? Today's the day. Yeah, you don't know what I'm talking about? Let me show you. Come on over here. Let me show you why today is the day. We got my man, Bill, from A to Z Mobile Repair. Look at him. Fixing the Ding Ding 2.0. Finally, we're going to be able to use this. If you guys want Bill's info, here you go. A to Z Mobile RV Repair, that's his phone number, but he's extremely busy. You got to give him like a week or two in advance because, well, the guy's just slam busy. But I'm just glad that he's finally here to fix this thing. And for you guys, when I said it was or when we thought it was going to be easy to take apart, clearly it's not going to be, because you can see he's got to pretty much pull everything off. And once he gets it all off, I'll show you guys sort of what you have to take off, but it's not an easy job, that's for sure. Well, it's not working from the outside, guys. We got the slide in probably an inch or two. He's got to have to try to go from the inside of it because he can't reach the screw that's in there. So he's going to get some other tools, and I'll show you over here what he's trying to do. So it looks like it's a pretty pain in the butt if it's stuck open. So there's three screws, he said, in here, behind here, that he's gonna try to get off, because we got this in, I don't know even if you guys can, yeah, you're probably not gonna see it, but we got it in just a little bit. So if he can get those three screws out, he said he might be able to do it from there. All right, guys, well, it's out, he got it out. That was fast, but it's a pain in the ass. But Bill knows what he's doing over here, clearly. So you guys can see there that the wires, thank you, sir. These wires, and you said, Bill, one is for alignment and these two are for?
Two are for the motor.
Okay.
The black and red probably go to the motor.
Okay.
And the rest are for a sensor in there to
align it proper.
So that both sides go out.
Okay.
So they stop at the same place.
Okay. So is there anything you can suggest to them to secure this, or no way? Not really. I mean, what, like, there's got to be something to prevent this. I mean, how are we going to do it to the other side to prevent it from happening to the other side? Just pray? I mean, you know.
The only thing I could do is put a wire tie to hold it back out of the way. That's the only thing I could do.
Okay. We can't wrap this. I figure we just wrap it with some heat shrink.
No, I don't think that's going to help.
Why not? It's just going to prevent from one of these grabbing onto one of those bolts over there. Because I think that's what happened. This grabbed on a bolt, one of those bolts,
so
that was up there.
Back on the other side, away from that, I think we're going to be good.
Okay, well, you let me know. Because if not, you're going to be hearing from me again. I'm going to have to call you out here.
Yeah.
So, hopefully it's stuck here at the house, not out of campground, though.
Yeah.
Like the same? Hopefully.
Yeah, it does.
Okay. And then, guys, for that, how he popped it out, so we took all this apart. You can see we got the slide. It's kind of, you know, cockeyed like this. And he pretty much just lifted it right out. I would assume there's a groove that little motor sticks in, or that, because there's a flat part on there. So you have to make sure you clock it right when you put it in. And then just unplug it, pops right out. And then we'll see how we're going to secure it so this doesn't happen again.
Top of the motor.
All right, let's check this out, guys. Okay, so
they're going to be right on top of the motor.
Okay.
Tie wrap on it right there.
Oh, yeah, you'll pretty much tuck it in.
Way away from the root.
Okay. So Bill's going to do it like this, guys, which is a lot better, because before it was going this way, so it was catching, or did catch on one of these, so we're gonna do it the Bill way, and see how it goes. Now, can you do that to the other side too?
We can look at it and see.
If we can, yeah, maybe once it's working, pull it in. It's easier. You said it's easier to get to when you can pull them in. Sometimes.
We'll check it out and see.
Okay. See. Because, guys, if it's, you know, the same like that on that side, it's only, you know, bound to happen that it's gonna catch something and rip. Look who's arrived, guys. My man Jerome. Bringing me that alkaline. Say what's up to the YouTube. What's up, John?
Hello.
How you doing, brother? You bringing me some water? Loading me up? So, guys, if you're wondering, you guys ask me where I get all my alkaline from, man. Right here. The alkalator. This is the alkalator mobile. So if you see this thing, you know, don't jack it, because all you're going to get is water out of it. That's it. Some high-quality H2O. Ooh, baby, look at that thing. Loaded. How many cases you bring me today?
I was told 20.
20? Perfect. All right.
You all right with that?
Yeah, yeah, that's fine. I told Martin I want to figure out a way, get a spot so you can just bring me a pallet. Set the pallet, boom, be done with. But I don't know. Jerome's like, yeah, I don't know if I want to unload a pallet, man.
You gotta unload a pallet.
Yeah, there you go. But guys, I mean, we're running out of room over here, so that's why we got to figure out a room to put the alkylate water in. I made a spot for you, Jerome. Same spot as usual. And look at that, guys. Look at that. Woo! That's that high quality H2O. Okay, guys, so the motor is done. It's got everything put back together. Now you have to go into the controller box here, which is, in my situation, in the bathroom. Pull the drawers out. And then if you take a photo of it, you just took a photo of it, you can see where it's got a reset option. It has, alignment, I would assume. So we're doing alignment. And you got to pretty much sync the motors proper so they go in and out evenly. So that's what he's figuring out right now. And then we should be all done. Well, guys, just like that, built to carry it. It wasn't too bad. I got to say it took him probably two and a half hours. And so what he pretty much did was so this side, you don't have to, we figured out you don't got to pull this side out, pop this out. You have to loosen this rail, loosen that rail, and this loosen all this, and this you have to, it'll pretty much pop out. So we put the slide in just a little bit, so as pretty much as it will go in. And then when he took these out, he popped it out, and that gave him room to stick his hand up in there to pull the motor out and to get it replaced. Unfortunately, you got to do the same thing to this side right here, but he couldn't get to us. So what we did was we just tried to tuck those wires in as good as possible. So hopefully we don't have the issue, you know, with this side now. Well, what in the, why is it black like this? Little desert sand in the lens over here, guys. Not opening up all the way. There you have it, guys. It is fixed. So now we're going to go ahead to the racetrack. Go start the rammer up. And we're going to go ahead to our local racetrack, SDRC here, if you guys are in San Diego. Come on by. And only reason, well, because I think me and Nick are going to run the finish the whole JBRL race. I figured, I told him, we'll take the toy hauler, you know. Ding Ding's working good so far. Got another appointment on the 23rd at John's. He's going to fix the LED strip. It's like falling off and wavy. It's not straight. But also, we're going to get rid of that top AC that's a 13.5. We're going to put a 15 BTU in there and duct it. So we have, you know, more power. Obviously, more power is always, you know, more better. More power, baby. More power. So, anytime you got more power, it's good. Also, guys, there's one thing I forgot to mention. Actually, I will come in here and show you. But is how to... So if you guys are going to put the new motor in yourselves, which that's fine. But I forgot to mention on how to get it to align it, basically, is what I'm trying to say here. So what you got to do is when you have that out, what he read, what it said was on your switch in here, you need to put this in 5 to 10 inches, the slide, back and forth. 5 to 10 inches, little by little. And that's how you, it said anywhere between 10 to 15 times. And that's how this thing adjusts from making sure it's going in, you know, or not one side hits, where it goes in nice and flush for you. That's how, or that's according to what it says on the sticker that's in here. And on this toy hauler, like I said, I don't know if it's all the same, but on my current model, it's in here where the bathroom is on the closet. Just pop the drawers out and it will come out. But I can't guarantee you that it is going to be the same thing. But if you guys remember, the problem that I was having was that side was stuck and was not opening. Only this side would come in, this side would not. And also stay tuned for the, the buffing stage or something. So Nick brought me over some product and we're gonna try it. I'll let you guys know if it works on boats, because I had a lot of you guys DM me saying, Eddie, what product do you use to clean the boat with? How do you get it shiny? Believe it or not, the boat is not that shiny. I mean, not up to my standards, at least, because if you look sort of like right here, you see how this white, it's not like a clean white, but look right over there. You see how this looks? See what that looks like right there? Then that looks like right there. So here, I'll even show it to you. I don't even know if I can show you from this angle. There you go. See that? Look at it. See that? See how it looks like it's unfocused, dirty, not clean, and that looks solid? That's how we're going to try to make this whole entire boat just like that. And then we're going to purchase, so Nick found a website. I'll let you guys know when Nick finds out, but a ceramic, I guess it's a ceramic coating for marine stuff to prevent it, because here's a problem I have with this boat. So this boat, when it's in the water, or well, especially when you're on a plane, you're driving, the water is, you know, it goes to about like here, you know, and starts coming down. Well, the problem is the water, it like starts fading all of this. See this? See these right here? How it looks like it's spotted. You can barely see it. That is from the water. Well, supposedly, I'm gonna buff the whole thing, and then Nick's gonna bring this product, and we're gonna put it on the entire boat, and hopefully it will protect it. See, it's supposed to look like that. You see how that's nice? You know, there's no, like, spots on it. But it's hard to do it when that's the side that's, you know, you're doing 50 mile an hour on the water, and it's just cutting right through it. So we're gonna see if we can bring it back to life, protect it, and then I'll let you guys know on that. And then also let me know, please, if you guys know a good painter. I'm gonna get this trailer repainted to get rid of all this rust on it. So we're gonna pull the boat off, send this out, and get this all painted, done, put some new rims, tires, make it, you know, look nice, get it ready for river season. Actually, river season started, but just get it cleaned up a little bit. That's all I got for you guys for today's video. Stay tuned for the next vlog. If you guys like this video, don't forget to hit that thumbs up button. Don't forget to click subscribe. Peace.